This is the BBC Light Programme.
From the book, I Knew Terence Nuke by Eileen Beardsmore Lewisham, Tiddly-Doo Spot, we present the play I Knew Terence Nuke from the book by Eileen Beardsmore Lewisham.
It can be cold in London. Damn cold. On such a night as this, 80 years ago, a ragged idiot staggered into a 40-year-old fog-laden limehouse area.
It's me, folks. Nelly Seagun. Ah, here it is, Christmas Eve, and still no offers of pantomime. And not a penny have I towards a plate of victuals for me poor half-starved 18-stone body. So I lay me poor old 20-stone head down on this 8-stone embankment bench. Ah, this is nice and soft.
Not call your line on me.
Hello,
hello. Oh, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
I wouldn't mind, but I got friends to tell you. They're traveling south.
You two men, what are you doing now?
What?
I'm moving on now. That bench is for royalty of no fixed abode.
Constable, have pity. It is Christmas, the time of goodwill.
Truth, so it is. Well, a Merry Christmas on you, mate.
And the same to you.
Now move along there before I belt you.
Guardian, tip-top time.
The voice came from a man with a military bearing, which he tossed in the air and caught. He emerged from the darkness and walked into the light.
Now, policeman, how would you like to join the river fleet?
Oh, I'd like that, sir.
Thank you, sir, and a Merry Christmas for you. Merry Christmas.
The stranger now turned his glance on me. He observed my shredded paper suit, my thrice-turned overcoat, and my toes sticking out of the end of my feet.
Down on your luck?
Why are you interested in me?
I run a rag and bone shop.
Looking for a manager?
No, I'm looking for stock. However, I have a friend of mine, a bank manager in the Bank of Twickenham, the Honorable Finn, Great Five Finn. How are you at mathematics?
I speak it fluently.
Touché. Very well. Take this tray and present yourself to him tomorrow.
Seagun's wife was overjoyed at Ned's luck. He started work as a bank clerk with every prospect of becoming one.
My wages were 8 shillings a week, with an allowance of 3 shillings for each child.
This brought his money up to £80 a week.
That was the manager, Mr. Thin, well known in concentric circles.
Mr. Seagun, how long have you been with us?
20 minutes.
What a splendid record of devotion and honesty. Neddy, and this is where the story really starts. Neddy, I'm putting you in a position of trust. You're going to be in charge of the gold vault. Here is the key.
Gold? Gold! Gold! Lovely gold! I'll be rich. No more rags for me. Gold! Gold!
I wonder if he's the right man for the job.
I decided to pinch the gold. Immediately, I backed a large horse-drawn motor van up to the front entrance of the bank.
Yeah, you come, park that there, sir.
The constable, how would you like to join the river police?
I'd like that very much. Thank you very much.
And a Merry Christmas. Now, carry on, Neddy.
Yes, it's a lovely day for carrying on, Neddy.
Right. Next, I carefully disguised myself as a Zulu warrior of the Matabili Rising. So cunning was my makeup, not even my own grandmother would have recognized me.
Hello, Neddy.
Hello, Granny. In this inconspicuous disguise, I took the gold from the vaults and loaded it onto the van. For 3 hours, I toiled back and forth.
Oh, Neddy.
Curses, I'm spotted.
Why are you wearing that leopard skin?
So that's why I'm spotted.
Tell me, where are you taking that gold?
I had to think of a good excuse.
You're stealing it, aren't you, Neddy?
Blast! Why didn't I think of that?
We will have to give you a week's notice.
Why? What have I done?
Nothing, but we're having to cut down on staff. You see, there's been a robbery. You get that van started while I get my hat and coat.
You coming too?
There's no point in staying. There's more money in the van than there is in the bank.
Very well, we'll be partners.
Sheik.
I'll give you my hand.
I gave him my foot. It was a fair swap.
Ying dong, it'll I fall.
Good, and for no reason, Max Conk Skeldrick.
Huzzah! Ah!
Dishonored, Part 2. And this is where the story really starts. With their newfound wealth, Ned painted the town red. Then the first blow fell.
Ginny, bad news. The bank you stole the gold from told the police.
What a rotten trick. Here's nothing sacred.
Give yourself up, Neddy.
Give myself up? No, I can't break myself of that habit. What about the gold?
Leave that with Moriarty. And when you come out in 89 years, we will be waiting for you. Won't we, Moriarty?
No, no, no. I couldn't keep you waiting all that time. I mean...
Then you'll have to go abroad, won't he, Moriarty?
Abroad?
Of course.
But my wife, I can't leave her with 38 children.
Isn't that enough?
Yes, I suppose the rest would do her good, yes.
Yes, then it would do you good, too, you naughty boy. What, Carl?
Oh, yeah. As they say in Paris.
How will I get the gold out of the country?
Well, you box clever there. You leave the gold with us, and when you return, we will be waiting.
I'll flee the country. We sail at dawn. Tonight! Within a week, we were on board a private yacht, sailing west, northeast, south. I stood in the pilchard with a spanker blowing through my hair and the salty bloaters spinning before the goblets. It's a man's life, I tell you. A man's life, I tell you.
I'm so sorry, Ned. Never throw into the wind.
Hello, Captain Finn. What's our position?
Desperate. I mean, I'll inquire. Navigator.
Can you restitute our position in the med? What's that object of the port beam?
Yeah. What is that object of the port beam?
Good heavens, it's the Albert Hall.
You've been to sea before.
But what is the Albert Hall doing off Beachy Head?
More to the point, what is this ship doing in Hyde Park?
Well, the sea's calmer here.
You idiot, we're 4,000 miles off course.
Nobody perfect.
Shut up, Eccles.
Shut up, Eccles.
I'm sorry you can't park this yacht here.
Constable,
how would you like to join the Kensington Round Pond, please?
There ain't no such force.
You're the first.
Thank you, sir.
Good on you.
Dishonored, Part 3. In the Mediterranean, and this is where the story really starts. In the med, the blow fell. One morning, Neddy was called to the captain's cabin.
Neddy, when you came aboard, I believe you deposited all the gold in the care of Moriarty.
Yes. Why? Isn't it safe with him?
Oh, it's perfectly safe. Wherever he and his rowing boat are.
The gold I stole? Stolen? A thief. Which way did he go?
I pointed a finger.
Gone?
Yes. Now let's go down and divide the gold, Maria.
That's a good plan. That's a good plan to me.
Oh, for the dogs, the boss!
Oh! Meantime, I floundered alone in the Indian Ocean, unable to speak a word of the language. I saw on my back, side, front and knees, but I just couldn't get off to sleep.
Oh, I'm a sure skew to move along, sir.
Oh, it's you, Constable. I thought you were in the river police.
Yes, right, sir, Yun.
Then, what are you doing in the ocean?
I've been promoted, sir.
Congratulations. Could you direct me to India?
Just follow the tram lines.
Thank you. And so saying, I struck out for the shore.
10 miles he swam. The last three were agony.
They were over land. Finally, I fell in a heap on the ground. I've no idea who left it there. Then I heard the approach of a high-powered horseless carriage with a long dongler attachment and a brown card with the word "Fatang" on it in Greek.
Oh, tightening. We are doing 3 miles an hour.
We're married in our beds. Oh, dear.
Put the brake on, Min.
Doesn't suit me, Henry.
No.
Where is it, Henry?
It's in a brown paper parcel under my seat,
Min. Oh, dear. Stand up, then. Oh.
I can't stand up, motoring, Min. I'll lose my leather control. Dear me.
What?
The wick in the engine's gone out.
What's that? What's that? Oh, it's a young... What? You're a young man. What are you doing under that car, young man?
I'm not doing anything under your car.
Thank heaven for that.
I am Henry Muttering Cran. We are anxious to know if you need succor.
Yes, just what I need, a glass of succor.
Why don't you answer us, sir?
Hitting with on the conch, hitting.
What?
Hitting with a pudding in the...
Are you both deaf? I've told you I'm weak from exhaustion. Of course, that's why they can't hear me. I'm unconscious.
Oh, man, you heard what he said. He's unconscious.
Yes,
unconscious.
Can't you? Help me lift him up, Min. I'll take his head.
Okay.
And you... No, you go around the other side of his head. Yep.
Other side?
The other side.
Oh, dear.
That's right, Mim. Have you got that a strap inside?
Yes, Henry.
Now, here is Dishonoured, part four. Tied to the back of Krun's car, Seagun was towed back to Pune, but the rope broke and left him stranded in the Indian quarter of Bombay.
Yes, in the street of 1,000 households. There is a place where a man can drink and forget his sorrow.
What does the dirt-encrusted Saab desire? All the sensuous drinks of the Orient are yours. The Panbidi, the scented Vishnu wine, the toddy juice, the aromatic Rabhani. Which do you desire, O wicked one?
Pot of tea, please.
Oh, well.
Ladies and European-type gentlemen, taking your modern European-type partners for the English-style cabaret.
From this moment on, you for me, babe, only two for tea, babe, from this moment on. From this happy day, no more blue songs, only hoop-de-doo songs, from this moment on. You got the love I need so much. You've got the skin I love to touch. You've got the arms to hold me tight. You've got the sweet lips to kiss me goodnight. From this moment on, you and I, babe, we'll be flying high, babe. All our cares have gone from this moment on. The love I need so much. You've got the skin, oh, I love to touch. You've got the arms, those loving arms to hold me tight. You've got the sweet lips to kiss me goodnight. From this moment on, you and I, babe, we'll be flying high, babe. All our cares have gone from this moment, from this instant, from this magic moment on.
Part of the cabaret, the mysterious Parabidi at an extra 4 rupees.
Good.
Oriental Queen will do the dance of the 7 army surplus blankets. Here she comes, a creature of divine beauty.
Into the middle of the floor sprang a creature who set my pulses racing. One by one, the blankets fell to the floor. The lights went down. As the last blanket fell from the passionate creature, I moved to her side in the dark. What is that of a creature? What prompts you to dance in this den of vice?
I got on my collar in two, you know.
Nichols, you're not a woman.
I know that. I can't tell the manager.
Why not?
We're engaged. It's going to be hell, folks.
How many did you get here?
Well, that fellow Moriarty and Grandpa Payne, they threw me into the sea.
So there is some good in them after all.
All right, I'm going to murder a lot.
Where are you, darling?
Oh, here he comes. Look out. Keep him away. The question is, what are we going to do now?
I'm going to clear my name and get back my self-respect. I'll join the Navy. It's too damn noisy in the Navy. Come at all!
Oh, no more curried eggs for me. So, you two naughty men want to join the Bombay Irish, do you?
Aye, Jockman.
Aye, aye, buddy.
Well, it's a tough life, I'll tell you. Do you know what it's like to be in the thick of a bloody battle with bullets flying and sabers clashing?
No.
Pity, I was hoping you'd tell me what it was like. You see, I'm writing a book entitled Blood Knock VC. However, let us take the regimental oath. Are we ready?
You are.
Now open your wallet and say out to me, help yourself.
Help yourself.
Thank you. Do you swear to be brave soldiers?
Yes.
Never turn a back on the enemy?
Never.
Always speak well of a lady?
Always.
And respect the chastity of a woman?
Yes.
Have we got nothing in common? Still, we are in need of a couple of ripe steamers. You see, the Red Bladder is raising the Pathan tribes. He's got fresh consignments of automatic swords and a touch of the Rangoon crap thrown in.
Where did he get the finance?
Two international crooks smuggled him a shipload of gold saxophones.
Good pub of Moriarty. Now that's the game. Wow. Sir, I have a score to settle. Let me go to the frontier.
Right, Sidness.
Eddie Seagull. There. Am I a soldier now?
I've no idea. I only collect autographs, you know. Seagull, arm the men to the teeth.
Impossible.
No arm?
No teeth.
Then we can't fight.
Sir, I want a chance to prove that I'm a man.
Report to the M.O.
I'll fight the Mad Muller, clear my name and recover the gold, and capture Moriarty and Gritpipe thin into the bargain. Who will ride with me?
Ensign Bluebutter will. Thank you. See, my sword is in my hand. Oh, the end's fallen off.
Little Jughead Bugler, blow the alarm.
That is what I say. Bloody alarm. Play another game, please.
This is no game, little drooping seat. Get mounted, lad.
Yes, my captain. I'm mounted in and ready for the ride. But hey, wait a minute. What's this in the saddlebag?
That's dynamite, lad.
Yeah, you're not starting that luck again, are you?
We'll soon know the valid truth. To horse!
Can I come through?
It's about time you came to. I've made a little jacket.
Guess what I'm getting on my birthday.
What are you getting, Echo?
I'm getting a bow wow.
Oh, I'm not getting a bow wow. I'm getting a junior smoker's kit. Complete with coffee, ashtray, and licorice dogging.
I like licorice. My mother said that licorice gives you a good run for your money.
Here came a pass! Forward!
All that night I rode, and through the best part of the next day.
You left the worst part to us. Joke my knee. My prunes are fumed.
And this is where the story really starts.
Oh, look, my cousin, look. Points cardboard finger at thousands of savage, naughty men with Indian type bare, bumpy old chest.
The red bladder is 50,000 balloons.
What?
Gad, we're outnumbered 20 to 1.
20 to 1? Time for lunch.
There's only one chance. Blue Bottle, ride to the crest of the crag and signal Major Bloodnock.
What is it, Mintage?
Tell him to keep two late dinners.
I will do it. I will. Ride, butter, ride. Yeah, wait a minute. Captain, in between me and that crag is a dirty big bar chasm with a 40,000-foot drop to the rising tide below.
Fear not, little shivering nut. That Arab stallion will bound that chasm like a winged arrow.
Yes, it will. Get up, Devin. You did not jump that chasm thing. And I've been hurled into the dreaded canyon, Splat-tad, Zer-plant-tad, and several other rockets in Nutsham.
Welcome to the Indian River Fleece, little boy of mine.
Oh, you're the forces of evil Maranatan men. Thinks I know how to get rid of the dynamite. Mr. Maranatan, would you like a nice big long red cigar with a wick on the end?
Oh, thank you, little boy.
Is it nice?
It's gone out.
I'll light it again for you.
Thought you'd like to hear it again.
Dishonoured, part the last. Neddy Seagoon gives his all in battle with the red bladder.
Ah, that battle raged. I heard it all on the wireless, you know. Seagoon fought like a madman. How else? But alas.
On that spot is now a little white stone.
Yeah, once a year, Min lays flowers on it.
The stone bears simple inscription in Hindustani.
I haven't the heart to tell her that roughly translated it says, Bombay, 49 miles. Good night.
That was The Goon Show, a BBC recorded programme starring Peter Sellers, Harry Secombe and Spike Milligan, with Ree Ellington and Max Galdry. The announcer was Wallace Greenslade. Music was by Wally Stott and the script was by Spike Milligan. The programme was restored by Ted Kendall and produced by John Ball.